Did both of you always, as you grew up and matured and started looking at, you know, post-high school, college, a career, did you always have similar career paths, or was there enough of a difference in your interests to lead you in different directions at some point?
Well, initially there was. I mean, I went to the U.S. Merchant Marine Academy, and Scott actually took a totally different path for a while, going to the University of Maryland for a year, and was considering maybe, you know, being a medical doctor, but decided, you know, my other interest was maybe flying airplanes in the Navy. Just kind of changed my mind and changed schools and changed majors and decided, you know, to focus 100% on that. So he's actually a year senior to me in the Navy. I actually remember going to visit him at the University of Maryland, probably towards the end of his first year, and then showing him all the pictures of Navy airplanes and telling him I was going to go ahead and do this.
That's not how I remember it.
And then he said something like,
"Yeah, right.
That sounds a lot better than being a doctor."
Not how I remember it.
No fist fights on the set.
Okay, so for you, Scott, ultimately you wound up with an interest in electrical engineering and ultimately aviation. Mark, what piqued your interest in maritime engineering and transportation?
Well, we spent a lot of time on the New Jersey shore. My parents always had a boat from the time we were very little. We'd go out fishing. We'd go down there usually for the summer.
Not like the TV Jersey Shore.
Yeah. So we go down there for the summer and spend a lot of time on the water. Later, when we were teenagers, we were able to stay down there in the summer by ourselves on our parents' boat. You know, not a big boat, like in the 35-foot range, but big enough for the two of us to live on. So I was very interested in, you know, seamanship and maritime-related stuff. So probably when I was 13 or 14, I started looking at either going to the Merchant Marine Academy or the Naval Academy or the Coast Guard Academy. But the Merchant Marine Academy really got my interest.
And for you, Scott?
Well, plus our grandfather was an officer in the U.S. Merchant Marine and a fireboat captain in New York City. So that was, I think, also played a small part in the interest in, you know, having a third mate's license, which I actually still have. I kind of kept it current all these years. And never actually thinking I would sail on the license. But the reason I went to the school that I did was because it was they had Navy ROTC there, and they also, it was a regimental type of environment. I thought it'd be better for me, giving more time to focus on schoolwork. And I was obviously right.
Which one of you decided to become a pilot first?
My recollection, it was me, but because he was a year ahead of me in college, he actually was in the Navy first and flew first, but that's just my recollection.
Yeah, I'm not sure.
And did that influence you to follow in his footsteps, basically?
You know, I was pretty committed to the Navy before he was, because I was on a Navy scholarship in college.
Yeah, it's true. I mean, I actually looked at even going, hate to say this, but for a while I looked at going into the Air Force. And actually considered it, took the test, and they offered me, you know, an option of going to Air Force flight school. And, you know, but certainly I'm pretty convinced I took the right path there. Nothing against the Air Force people out there, but.
You were both 5 years old when Neil Armstrong and Buzz Aldrin set foot on the moon on Apollo 11. What recollection might you have of that at that age, and ultimately, was that a big influence on your developing an interest ultimately in aerospace or space flight itself?
I don't think I have any recollection of Apollo 11 at all. I think at that age, I don't know what the situation was there, but I don't remember the significance, and I don't remember, you know, man first walking, taking the first steps on the moon. I do remember what I'm pretty sure was either Apollo 16 or 17, one of the later flights, a couple years later, and I was interested in it. It's one of those things when you're that age, you can be interested in something, but it just seems like it's so far off and so difficult to do that you don't really take a lot of time to consider it.
And I do have a recollection of it. I can remember being in my our living room and our parents, sitting us in front of the television and having us watch it. And but as far as did that influence me, you know, certainly being an astronaut was something that, like many kids, I was interested in, but, you know, I really never thought it would be a possibility.
So with that in mind, give us a little background on how you were both selected to join the Astronaut Corps at the same time, which is unique in of itself, which parallels many other events in your lives together.
Well, we both wound up in the same test pilot school class. We didn't apply at the same time. I was in graduate school in Monterey on this combined program, and which includes going to the Naval Test Pilot School, and then Scott applied to test pilot school. We actually wound up in the same class. The school didn't even realize it until, I think, a week before we showed up. And Dick Clark, who now works here at NASA, was looking through the roster. He was the chief flight instructor at the time. And he noticed two guys with the same last name, which, you know, that's kind of common, right? But then he noticed the Social Security numbers. And our Social Security numbers are three digits apart. And he was like, okay, well, these guys must be related. Or actually, he realized we must be twin brothers. So after test pilot school, I'd say most test pilots apply at some point to the astronaut program, and we both did, and were fortunate enough to be selected to the same class in 1996.
So Scott, it took you only 3 years after your selection before you flew in space for the first time as the pilot on STS-103, Hubble Space Telescope servicing mission. And Mark, you didn't fly until a couple of years later on your first flight, which went to the International Space Station. Was it frustrating for you, Mark, to see your brother fly first? Were those competitive juices flowing at the time?
Not at all. You know, he was the first American in our class to fly of 35. So it was great to, you know, if it wasn't going to be me, it was great that it was Scott flying for the first time. And then I think it was probably 2 or 3 years later that I had the opportunity to fly in STS-108. So